Hello everyone, I'm Tarun Kaushik and today in this class we will be doing analytical geometry part 6 and this will be the last lecture for the sphere. Okay, now let us proceed. So we were left with the this portion, two or more sphere. So the first topic of today we will be learning the angle of intersection of the two spheres. Okay, so this is the first sphere and this is another sphere. So where this angle of incidence, or you can say intersection, will be formed. For example, this is a sphere and this is a tangent to this plane, okay, to this sphere, and at the same point, for example, this is another sphere and this is another tangent plane to this point, to this plane or this sphere. So this point P, I'm assuming this point P, so if I join this radius from the center, or consider that if I join this point P to the center, then this radius R1 and R2 will make an angle. That angle is called as theta. Okay, now as you can see over here, this point P, the angle formed is nothing else, it is just theta value, and it is given by the cosine of angle, that is R1 square, that is the radius of the first sphere, and R2 the radius of the second sphere, minus the distance between the two centers of these two spheres, divided by twice of the radius of these two spheres. Okay, it is just simple formula, you can remember it and solve the various questions. Now, orthogonal spheres. For example, the formula was cos theta is equals to R1 square plus R2 square minus D square divided by twice of R1 into R2. Okay, this was the formula as we just discussed. This is the formula. Now, at orthogonal, this cos theta will become 90 degree. So, just put equals to 0 and find out the condition. So, we get this R1 square plus R2 square comes out to be D square. When we put this value of theta equals to 90, then we get this condition. Okay, now this condition will be very, very much helpful in solving the further questions. Okay, now, so what should be the condition of orthogonally? For example, these two are the sphere, the spheric equation. Now, what should be the condition of the orthogonal? Now, this is the sphere equation, this is another sphere equation. Now, the center of the first sphere and the radius of the first sphere is given by this formula, and the center of the second and the radius of the second is given by this formula. Since we know that this is the formula of you can say that relation between the sphere radius and the distance between the center of two different spheres. Okay, so just use this formula and you can say that put them equal and find out the relation between these two spheres. Now let us proceed. This is nothing, this is R1, this is R2. Okay, R1 square plus R2 square equals to D square. D square is nothing, it is just the distance between the centers of two different spheres. Okay, so after that we came to know about this equation, that is twice of U1 U2 and twice of the V1 V2 and twice of the W1 W2 equals to the distance between these two points, that is D1 plus D2, or you can say that coefficient portion of the spheric equation. Okay, so now let's proceed. Now we will solve some questions. Now show that these two sphere, this sphere and this sphere, cut orthogonally. So what we have to do, just substitute the value in that this formula, 2u1 u2 plus twice of v1 v2 plus twice of you can say that w1 w2 equals to d1 plus d2. Just remember this formula whenever you find any orthogonal property, just use this property and put these values. So we know that this calculate the center and the radius of the first, center and the radius of the first, or even not, even we are not required to calculate the radius. Okay, just put these, you can say that u1 v1 w1 d1 u2 v2 w2 d2, just calculate these values and put these values into this you can say that equation. If both comes equal, then it means these two spheres are cutting at orthogonal, at right angle, otherwise not. Okay, now the next question. We have to find out the spheric equation which touches this plane at this point. Okay, this is the sphere, at this point it is touching this plane and it cut orthogonally. Whenever you find orthogonally, it means we have to use this property, that is twice of u1 u2 plus twice of v1 v2 and so on. Now, so we know that this point P is present on this sphere and this plane also, so it means this plane is tangent to this sphere. So using the property of tangent, what is the property of tangent? We have discussed in the last video and you can watch from there what was the condition. But now I'm telling you what was the condition, is that just substitute this point into the main equation of sphere. For example, this is the spheric equation which we want to calculate. So here you can find out this is x square. So we have to put the value of one coordinate of this x axis in the value of x. For example, this is x square. So I can write it x into x. So one of the value of x, I have to put it x1. And where, what is x1? This is equals to 1 here. So just substitute this x of 1, y minus 2, g1, u of x plus 1. I already discussed this in the last lecture. You must know, okay? Now, just substitute this value, you get this point. Or you can say that this equation, it is nothing, it is just a plane equation, okay? We will be doing the complete plane in the next upcoming lectures. Full, you can say that plane will be discussed complete in the complete detail, okay? Now, this plane equation and this plane both are parallel to each other. So what does it mean? The direction cosine this and this and this 3, 2 and minus 1 both will be in the same proportion. Just use this property of same proportion, because both the planes are equal, so their direction cosine will be in the same proportion. So just use that same proportion formula and say that this is equals to k. So I find out the value of u, v, w in the form of k, and d will be coming in the form of u, v and w. Since u, v and w, this is u, v and w, all these three values are in the form of k values. So just substitute this value here, u, v, w, so get the value of d in terms of k only. So this is the value of d in the k terms only. Now, you can say that mentioned this point, that this is orthogonally. So we have to use the property twice of u1, v2 plus twice of v1, v2 plus twice of w1, w2, that is equals to d1 plus d2. So this is the property which we have to use. So just this is the property. I could have shown this property to you right here instead of writing. So just use this property, put the value, calculate the value of d, okay? Now, not the value of d, value of k. So just substitute the value of k back into the equation of u, v and w and get the value of u, v, w and d. Since we are having all these values, just substitute the value and get our equation of the sphere which is required. Next, we have to find out the radius. These two spheres R1, R2 cuts orthogonally. So we have to prove that the radius of the common circle is this sphere, these cutting each other at orthogonally having the radius r1 and r2. So we have to find out the radius of the common circle. For example, this is the common circle x square plus y square plus equals to a square, where a is the radius of the common circle, g is equals to 0. We are assuming that in the g plane it is not in the, it is only lying in the xy plane. Now the this, since this you can say that g is 0, so I can write in the spheric equation that is plus g square, because g is nothing, it is 0. So I can write in so that it will look in standard form. That's why I did it. Now the equation of two sphere, since this is, these are the two spheric equations, so one single equation can be written by this formula. For example, k1g and another factor, you can say that another parameter, this is k2g. So these two are cutting at orthogonal. So just use the property of orthogonal. Okay, just use the property of orthogonal, find out the value of k1 and k2 equals to minus 4a square, and calculate the radius of the first sphere and radius of the second sphere. And you know that this is k1 and this is k2. So find out the value of k1 in terms of r1 and find out the value of k2 in terms of r2. So just substitute this value k1, k2 here and equate. When you do it, when you equate these two values, you get your answer, that is a value, which is nothing, it is just r1 r2 upon r1 square plus r2 square and under root. Okay, now we will be doing the length of the tangent. So this is sphere, this is center, and this at the, then there is some point, let us suppose this, whose coordinates are x1, y1 and g1. So this point t is at you can say that this t point is present on this tangent line. So this tangent to, if I increase this radius to this tangent point, so it will make angle of 90 degree. So I have to calculate the value of this PT, so it becomes a triangle, right angle triangle. Okay, so this PT square will be equals to PC square minus CT square. This PC I can calculate because x1, y1, g1 I already know, this is the coordinate of this point, and center of the sphere I can find out from the using the our property. We can say that minus u, minus v, minus w, it is already given. This point t, how to calculate this CT. This CT will be, this is a line, okay, this is will be a line which is passing from this point x1 y1, okay. So this is a, you can say that a straight line which is passing from a point, but instead of that what we can do is that this CT is nothing, this CT is already our radius only. So there is no need of calculating the perpendicular line from this point to the you can say that tangent, or you can say that this is a tangent only. So there is no need of calculating the, if calculate this value and find out the perpendicular distance, because this perpendicular distance is nothing, this is just the radius only. So the radius we already know by using this formula. So just put them equal and find out the value of PT. So our PT comes out to be this, that is x1 square plus y1 square plus g1 square plus 2u1 x1 plus twice of v y1 and this, okay, you know. Now what you have understood from this point is that whenever there is a tangent line to a sphere, from we have to calculate the, you can say that length of this tangent line, then this tangent line will be equals to, just substitute this point into the equation of the sphere, okay, and this point is also called as the, you can say that power of the plane. So and this is the radical plane. For the for understanding this radical plane, we have to learn one small topic, and the topic is, I just forget to take the snapshot of that, but I will be explaining here. This is a sphere, and this is a line which is starting from P point, it is Q point, intersecting at Q and going up to R. So if this point PQ and this PR length up to this PQ and this complete PR, if I multiply these two, PQ into PR, if these comes out to be a constant, then I will say that this point P, this is nothing, it is just the power of the plane, power of the plane. Okay, this is power of the plane. How to calculate? Just substitute this point into the spheric equation, get the point. So get the power. So power is nothing, it's just a numerical value. Okay. Now we have to find out the radical plane. What is radical plane and how to find out it? So equation of the radical plane, it is, you can say that this is a sphere. So the intersection of these two, it will give me the radical plane. Okay. So and this radical plane, as you can say that this is a center C1, this is a center C2. If I join these two center, then this plane will be perpendicular to each other. Okay, because perpendicular to not to each other, perpendicular to the line which is joining these two centers. Okay. So radical plane will be always equal to the line which is joining that center of the two different spheres. Now, this is the first spheric equation, this is the second equation. Now you can say that this point, for example, at a point P1, so the power of this point will be, just replace this x, y, g by x1, y1 and g1. And in the next also replace this x by x1, y1 and g1. So you get the power, since this power should be equal. Okay, at the same point, the spheric equation, the power should be equal. Just substitute these two powers equal and we get this plane equation that we will call as the radical plane. Okay, radical plane is calculated at the power. So what you have to do, just you can say that just substitute the value of x1 x y g as x1 y1 g1 to the point and get your answer. Now the property of radical plane, already discussed the two radical plane of the true sphere perpendicular to the line joining them. Okay, so there is no need of driving it, you can do it. Radical of a plane sphere passes through the point of intersection, no need of doing it. Now the equation of two spheres in simplified form. This is one spheric equation, this is another spheric equation. So I am assuming that these two centers are lying on the x-axis, so it means the radical plane will be in the g-axis, yg plane. Why? Because if I am assuming that this is x-axis, this is my x-axis, then this plane which is perpendicular, so we know that these two planes, x-axis, y-axis and g-axis, all these three are perpendicular to each other. Okay, so x-axis is perpendicular to both x-axis, y-axis as well as to the g-axis. Okay, now this is our first equation, this is our second equation. Just calculate the center of the first and second, because, and just substitute the value of y equals to 0, g equals to 0, because the centers are lying on the x-axis only. So after that, we have equations reduced to this one. Now just calculate the radical of these planes. When we put them equal, these three get cancelled, so we are left with this portion only. Okay, so radical plane will be twice u1 minus twice of u2 into x minus equal plus d1 minus d2. Okay, so this will be our radical plane. Now, since this, I already mentioned that this is a sphere, this is a sphere, this is a center line joining, and this is the radical plane, and it is perpendicular, and it is present in the yg plane, and in the yg plane, the value of x will be 0. So my this term will get cancelled. So we are left with only d1 minus d2 equals to 0. So it means that both the d equals to some value. You can say that both are value, both are equal. So d1 equals to d2, and that is equals to d, I am saying. So just substitute this value, d1 equal to d2. So we are left with this equation, okay? Now, which we have to just simply prove. Okay, now. If s1 equals to 0, s2 equals to 0, these are the two spheres, then the equation s1 plus lambda s2 equals to 0, where lambda is a parameter represented by a system of sphere, says that any two such members have the same radical plane. Okay, now this equals to 0, this is equals to 0. Now I can also write it s1 upon lambda 1 s2 divided by the coefficient of this s1 and the coefficient of s2, that is, I can divide both sides, so it will not make any change. And same here, okay. Now if I subtract these two, so I can get s1 minus s2, which give me a, and you can say that radical plane. Just subtract these two different plane to get our radical plane. Now coaxial system of sphere. What is coaxial? Coaxial means on these are lying on the same, you can say that same axis. All these sphere, the center present on the of different spheres are present on the same line. Okay, so these are coaxial system. Now there is nothing to do in this. This is same. This derivation is same. We just discussed above. Okay, where this you can say that this comes out to be okay. D equals to D. It is just same. Now limiting point of a coaxial. Limiting point is nothing. It is just the point where the because this point is very important, and from this topic the questions are being asked. Okay. Till now I haven't find, but the probability is that this year it may be found. Okay, you may find this type of question, because you can say that in 2016 the mains paper I predicted that from the numerical analysis paper the topic can come from the Gaussian quadrature. I predicted, though the question from the Gaussian quadrature was not asked from the last few years, when I predicted that this question might come, and this question was there in the paper. Okay, so I'm saying that this question, or you can say that the question on this limiting point can come this year in 2017. Okay, now see it. So we have to find out these two spheres of coaxial system. This is the sphere given, have the zero radius at this point. Okay, so what is the you can say that limiting point, the point at where the radius is zero. Just understand this portion. Okay, the value of the radius is zero at that point is called as limiting point. Now we have to prove it that at this point the radius will be zero. Now, or you can say that at this point, or you can say that we can take the radius as zero. So if we are taking that radius as zero, so we have to derive that the point will be this one. Okay, so this will be this is the given equation of the sphere, and the center is this and the radius is this. Since the radius is equals to zero at this point, so this value should be equals to zero, and u comes out to be this, u square equals to d, and u equals to plus minus d. So the point comes out to be plus minus d 0 0. So it means that at limiting point the value is 0 0. Okay, now we will do some questions now here. So we have to find out the limiting point of this coaxial sphere, we have to find out the you can say that limiting point. So how we can find out? This is s1, this is s2. Find out the radical plane. Okay, radical plane we have. Now the equation of the plane we are having, and then the sphere we are having. So what will be the equation of the sphere? The equation will be s1 plus lambda s2, or you can say that lambda s1 minus s2, because it is a radical plane. I'm again writing it. It will be s1 plus lambda into the equation of a plane. The plane equation is radical plane. And what is radical plane? Radical plane is nothing. It is s1 minus s2. So this is s1 minus s2 equals to 0, which is being a lambda j being parameter. So just substitute this value. Now it is saying that these are, we have to find out the limiting point. So we know that that limiting point, the radius is 0. Okay, so we can find out the center of this. Center is this, and the point D is plus 6 here. So just substitute this value, u square plus v square plus w square minus d equals to, and take the under root, it gives me the radius. Since this radius equals to 0, so from there we can find out the value of lambda. Okay, and the value of lambda comes out to be plus and minus 1. So after that we are having these two points. Okay, so put this value back into that equation, get the value of x, y, g, and that comes out to be this. Now find out the equation of the sphere which passes through the origin. You can see that 0, 0, coaxial with, now you see in this 3D or this 3D only analytical geometry, and you find that the questions are, you can see that you can, the examiner can frame any type of question. Okay, there's no surety it is which type of question he can form, because there are multiple way. Now you see, we have to find out the equation of a sphere through this point. Okay, the point is given, is this is coaxial the sphere, this spheric equation is given, and this is, you can say that coaxial with another sphere, and the equation of that sphere is giving from this point. Okay, and you can say that extremities of the diameter. So what it is saying, that we are given one point, that is origin, that is 0 0 0. This is the one point which we have given, and another spheric equation, this is the spheric equation which is given, and this, and another sphere which is, the equation of that sphere is not given, but what we have given, these two points, that this point and this point is given, so it forms a diameter. Okay, so from the diameter we can find out the equation of the sphere. So what will be the equation? This will be the equation. Okay, x minus x1 into y, x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 plus g minus g1 into g minus g2 equals to 0. So just substitute this value here and get your answer. Not answer, for the first answer you can say, this is the first spheric equation, this is the second spheric equation. Okay, and these two spheric equation we are having, and it is passing from this point. Now we can find out the intersection of that. You can say that these two sphere will be given by this formula, this first sphere plus k into k times the second sphere. And since we know that the value of the point, that is 0 0 0, it is passing from these both the points, the substitute this value of x, y, g as 0 0, you are left with only this post, this equation. So from there we get the value of k back. You can say that just substitute back this equation of k into this equation, find out this equation. Okay, this will be your required equation. Next, we have to prove that the locus of the point whose parameters are given with respect to two given spheres are a constant in ratio. Okay, so these two spheres are given, let us put these two spheres equations are given. So the power of the, let us put this is the point which is present on the locus. Okay, so the power of P with respect to this equation, so what is the power? Just substitute the value of x, y, g by x1, y1 and g1. Again in the second, just substitute what I mentioned in the power of a point, is that it is just a numerical value. For example, I am having 1, 2, 3, and this is equation x square plus whatever it is. Just substitute the value of x as 1, y as 2, g as 3, and find out a value. That comes out to be a numerical value. Okay, so this is a numerical value and this is a numerical value. When I divide this, that comes out to be a constant value, isn't it? So we get a constant value. Now when we get a constant value, so just substitute that value equals to k, and take, you can see that, do some cross multiplication, get your answer. Now show that the equation, this is the equation given where u in your parameter. Okay, there's no problem. Not passing from the limiting point. Now the point is limiting point. So whenever we, you can say that see this type of word limiting point, so radius should be 0. This point should automatically come to our mind. Limiting point means radius equals to 0 to this system, and cutting every member at right angle. So it means right angle, it is cutting at right angle. So the property of the orthogonal can be used. So these two property, by reading this question, that comes to our mind automatically. Okay, now see, this is the equation of the sphere which is given. Radius we can find out. Put the radius equals to 0, I already mentioned. Calculate that these two points we are having. Okay, now if we put these two points in the another spheric equation, it is satisfying. So it means it is, the point is correct only. Now it is also saying that this, the second sphere, this is cutting it orthogonally. Okay, and just use this property, orthogonally, that is twice of u1 u2 plus twice of v1 v2 plus this, And when we do this, it comes out to be true because 0 equals to 0. So it means it is cutting at right angle. So that we have to prove. Okay, so these are the questions for your practice, that you can do the practice from these two, these questions. And let me tell you, these questions are very important. Please, you can say that stop this, or you can say that the video, you can say the PDF of this lecture is already, I have already uploaded in the Google Drive. You can download it from there, and the link is described in the description below. Okay, and in the next lecture I will telling you the importance of these. Okay, so in this particular lecture that's all, and in the upcoming lecture we will be solving the plane, and you can say that lines and you can say the cone are still left. So there are two or three topics that are still left. We will try to do in the upcoming lectures. Okay, so in this particular lecture that's all. And if you really like this video, please click on the like button, because the response from you guys are very lukewarm. Okay, I'm not getting much views. The views are very less. So it, you can say that it motivates, if views are very high, then it motivates me also to make more videos, so that these are making much more sense. Okay, so though if any one person is still getting benefit, then I will still you can say that upload these videos. But as you can see, if more like or more demand will be there, then I will be excited to make much more videos more quickly. Okay, and please, you can also subscribe to my channel for getting the latest update directly into your email account. Okay, and that's all for this lecture. Thank you very much.